honor, adoration be to God Almighty for His sustenance, love, and mercies towards us. Highly esteemed listeners, welcome to the Oracles of God radio broadcast, a biblical program that is run and sponsored by the Churches of Christ, which come your way every Wednesday on Radio Universe 105.7 FM. Shall we commit ourselves to God in prayer? Holy, 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 everlasting God Almighty, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. We bless you, we glorify your greatness for your wonderful blessings you continue showering on us. Who are we that you continue to love us? Thank you for ushering us into this brand new week and day that you made us alive in the portion of the living. We acknowledge the fact that we are sinners, and the sins we commit, we do them. And therefore, we are at fault continually before thee. We ask that you continue to forgive us our sins, for such you sent your Son Jesus Christ to die for our sins. Cleanse us with the precious blood of your Son, and make us holy before thee. We're grateful to you once again that you made it possible to receive your oracles as pure, that will be able to build us in this world and the world to come. Once again, we thank you for the lives of the staff of the universe as they continue to transmit these your oracles. Bless them and guide them with your strength and abilities that these will be done successfully. Begin and end successfully with us. In the name above all names, Jesus Christ our Lord, do we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Distinguished listeners, we continue with a series of lessons we've started regarding a call for restoration. A call for restoration. For last week, we discussed about the differences between restoration and reformation. And we say that the restoration is very, very important today because when we look around in the Christendom, there is much confusion. That one needs not to tell you that all is not well. When we look around, as people have turned and reduced Christianity to businesses, personal businesses, where instead of preachers and evangelists, they have turned to be consultants, personal consultants as businesses, giving direction upon direction as to where they could be found with consultancy fees, not preaching the gospel, but alluding everything to something negative which doesn't come from God. When people have turned aside the Bible and are even doing what they think will help them fill their stomachs, when people are forming clues and strategies to outwit the innocent in the name of religion and Christ, when all these things continue to happen, in the midst of this, we call for a restoration. A restoration that people will read their Bibles again. A restoration that people will be restored to Christ Jesus himself. A restoration that people will move away from a situation where Christ has been shielded and people claim to have special relationship with him, so they should be consulted and contracted for the way forward. A restoration that any single little thing that happened to somebody, it means the person is not of God. And so false teachings all over that a Christian should never suffer, not even a headache. Any small thing that happens, it means we are not right with God. These are all fallacies and that people capitalize on to outwit the innocent. When we call for restoration, therefore, it's a serious business that we all should join to look for this restoration. Distinguished listeners, however, we warned last week that in the bid to restore, some people reform, and you say that reformation is an effort to make a religious institution better by improving on its existing structure or spirit or doctrine. And so people who started to reform, even though they thought they were restoring, reformed. And it's a reformation because they looked at a specific institution, say a church, and will look at that church to reform it instead of going back to the Bible for restoration. Reformation movements, we did see, promote division because the reformers can never agree upon a standard by which they will bring unity among themselves. And so we say reformations leave us with denominationalism. So most of the reformers, call them John Calvinists, Martin Luther's, John Wycliffe, John Knox and others, all who started to reform thinking they were restoring the church, they rather reformed the Roman Catholic Church that they thought that there were a lot of wrong things going on. They looked at the Roman Catholic Church to reform it instead of restoring in the Bible. 500 years ago, it has left us with much denominations. Distinguished listeners. And so we say reformations are inherently divisive. And so we shouldn't do that. Rather, we should restore. Because restoration is penetrate through the force in order to find the pure by using the Bible as the standard, not any particular church, not any particular institution. Restoration must never be sidetracked by reformation. Distinguished listeners. Today we continue by looking at a biblical restoration principle. A biblical restoration principle. Distinguished listeners, when we call for restoration, we are calling for all those who believe in Jesus as the Son of God to return to His Word as the final authority in all matters of faith and godly behavior. Fundamentally, we're asking people to start studying their Bibles again in order to make Jesus the center of reference for living by living according to His Word. When such happens, there will be an explosion of men and women returning to Christ simply because there is power in the Word of Christ to draw all men to Him. According to Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Hebrews 4, 12. Those who would herald the call for restoration will be those who are captives of the Word of God and that they esteem the Word highly in their hearts. Psalm 119, verse 11. Distinguished listeners, as captives of the Word of God in their hearts, restorationists call on all those who accept Jesus as the Son of God to return to the authority of His Word in their lives. In the apostate environment of the Israelites, who had strayed from the Word of God at the time God called Isaiah, so we would stand up and cry out to Christendom by quoting Isaiah chapter 8, verse 20. Isaiah 8, 20, and I read, "To the law and to the testimony, if they do not speak according to this word, it is because there is no light in them." Unquote. Distinguished listeners, we are also challenging religious leaders today that if they do not speak where the Bible speaks, then there is no light in them. Again, as Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16, Isaiah 34, 16 said, and I quote, "Seek out the scroll of the Lord and read," unquote. Distinguished listeners, we are also challenging every preacher today that is not seeking out the scroll of the Lord, the Bible, that he has no right to lead God's people. He is a blind guide for those who seek to walk according to the Word of God. Distinguished listeners, if we seek out the Word of God, then we can restore the right paths of God. According to Isaiah chapter 58, verse 12. Isaiah 58, verse 12. If we do not, then we will lead the people into error. Distinguished listeners, Unfortunately, most in Israel had no desire to restore themselves to the paths of God, since they had created a religion after their own desires, which religion was perpetuated by the hired false preachers. Isaiah 42 verse 22. We find the same truth today among religious groups who use the name Christian but refuse to turn to the word of Christ as their source of faith and authority in religious matters. It is for this reason that we call on all sincere and God-fearing people to take a stand for Christ and his word. Distinguished listeners, the two prophets, Jeremiah and Hosea, sought to restore the people of God who had forgotten the commandments of God. Hosea spoke for God by saying, and I quote, Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, "The my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge," unquote. "Because you have rejected knowledge, I will also reject you, so that you will be no priest to me. Seeing you have forgotten the law of your God, I will also forget your children." Hosea chapter 4 verse 6. Distinguished listeners, Jeremiah called for Israel to restore themselves to the old paths. In Jeremiah 6:16, he exhorted the people to turn again to the law of God. In Jeremiah 31:21-22, he proclaimed to the people that they are turned to walk down the bypaths of apostasy. In Jeremiah 18:15, distinguished listeners, it was a time in the history of Israel, therefore, when the people should have remembered and done their own ways, which ways were the ways of God. It is such a time today. We call on people to return to the scroll book of God in order to learn and walk in the paths of God. It is as one Bible staunch believer said, quote, "We need more teachers of the Bible," unquote. Jesus came into the world to restore Israel to submission to the word of God. He appealed to the religious leaders and said, "What is written in the law? How does it read to you?" Luke 10:26. Distinguished listeners, we need teachers who will teach us what is written in the law of God. Jesus' sentiment was continued by the apostles in 1 Peter 4:11. 1 Peter 4:11, and I quote, "If anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God," unquote. Distinguished listeners, where are all those teachers who will speak as the oracles of God? The plea of the apostles was, "What does the scripture say?" Galatians 4:30. We have for too long been listening to those who have no idea what the scriptures say, because they have trusted their own ability to speak and not in their study of the scriptures. We have been cursed long enough with biblically ignorant orators whose speech is sterile of the word of God. We are also burdened by those about whom Paul wrote in Romans 16:18. Romans 16:18 reads, "For they who are such serve not our Lord Christ by their own belly, and by appealing words and flattering speech deceive the hearts of the innocent," unquote. Distinguished listeners, we are exhorted to hold fast to that word that the apostles taught, as is stated in 1 Corinthians 15:2. "And if anyone will presume to be Christian among us, we would answer with Paul's affirmation in the context of those who sought to be the authorities of their own religiosity. For Paul said, and I quote, 'For I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified,'" unquote. 1 Corinthians 2:2. 1 Corinthians 2:2. Distinguished listeners, This we would demand of anyone who will stand before us and assume to be a spokesman for God. Since it is always the tendency of men to leave the authority of God, then it is a constant plea of sincere Bible-loving people to call for a continued focus on the right ways of God. If there is no one out there who is making the plea, then the misguided religiosity of men will take them further into a churchianity that is bankrupt of the word of God. And for such people, there is only one future, and that future is portrayed in the words of Jesus in Matthew chapter 7 verse 21. Matthew 7:21, and I quote, "Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven," unquote. Distinguished listeners, the people want to do the will of God, but in order for the will of the Lord to be done, we must know his will. And this takes Bible study. Lord, Lord, religionists will never call for a restoration if they do not get into the will, the word of God. Distinguished listeners, so that is the principle for restoration. Biblical study, back to the Bible. Restoring Bible studies. Restoring personal decision to study the Bible and do in accordance with the direction of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Distinguished listeners, shall we move on to foundation for restoration? Foundation for restoration. Our call for restoration is not without solid principles upon which we take our stand. In fact, the validity of any call for restoration must be based on the following beliefs. 1. Belief in a final authority. Believe in a final authority. Distinguished listeners, we must believe that God intended to reveal a final authority to man in all matters of faith. If God did not reveal a final authority in religious matters, then he left men to their own inventions. If there is no final authority, then every man is his own authority. And if every man is his own authority, then God cannot condemn us for inventing our own religious nonsense. This brings to mind the frightening statement of 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 9 to 12. 2 Thessalonians 2, 9 to 12, and I quote, "The presence of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan, with all deceiving power and signs and wonders, and with all deception of wickedness among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth, so that they might be saved. And for that reason, God will send them strong delusion, so that they should believe a lie, that they are who did not believe the truth, but took pleasure in wickedness," unquote. Distinguished listeners, we see the result today of religionists who have established their own authority in matters of faith. There is confusion in Christendom because men have no love of the truth. It is confusing because religious leaders are not faithful to the common foundation of God's revelation that will bring unity among all believers. Since many religious leaders have rejected the final authority of the Word of God, they've established their own authority and subsequently their own religions. The confusion we see in Christendom today is proof that men can never be their own final authority in matters of faith. Distinguished listeners, foundation number 2, believe that God's revelation is understandable. Believe that God's revelation is understandable. Distinguished listeners, we must also believe that God's absolute and authoritative revelation is understandable to the common individual without the necessity of any official interpreters. Division results when disciples terminate their personal study of the scriptures and subsequently give their brains over to official students of the Bible, the clergy. Preachers with advanced degrees in theology have intimidated the average member into believing that he has no chance of coming to a knowledge of the truth through simple Bible study. But we must never be deceived into thinking that it takes years of university study of the Bible to understand the fundamentals that are necessary for salvation. We must continually believe what Paul wrote to the average member of the church in Ephesus, in Ephesians 3 verse 4. Ephesians 3 verse 4, it reads, "Therefore, when you read, you can understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ," unquote. Distinguished listeners, it takes no Bible scholar to read the Bible and understand the mystery of Jesus Christ. The mystery of the gospel has been revealed because it can be understood by everyone. We must never accuse God of shrouding in a maze of obscurity that which is necessary to believe and obey in order to be saved. The Holy Spirit inspired the Bible to be written to common people, not scholars. Distinguished listeners, foundation number 3, believe that God's word has been preserved for all men. Believe that God's word has been preserved for all men. Distinguished listeners, we must also believe that God's revelation is preserved today in the form that God intended it to be preserved. It has been preserved in a manner by which it can be studied, and by such study, one can learn the way of salvation. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, 2 Timothy 3, 16 and 17, and I quote, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God, so that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work," unquote. Distinguished listeners, restorationists believe that the word of God is sufficient in its present written form to equip every person for every good work. Restorationists believe that the Bible alone is able to spiritually equip one for every good work. The Holy Spirit put about 1,500 years into the inspiration and writing of the Bible. One would be foolish to think that he will now lead us to ignore the scriptures which he took so long to have written. Since the Spirit put about 1,500 years into writing the Bible, we can put a lifetime in studying it. Distinguished listeners, foundation number 4, believe that God's word is all sufficient. Believe that God's word is all sufficient. Distinguished listeners, we must again believe that God intended for all those who would come to him must come to him on the basis of what is taught on his revelation. This is why Peter wrote that the disciples of Jesus have been born again, not by perishable seed, but imperishable, by the word of God that lives and abides. 1 Peter 1:23. Distinguished listeners, if one will be born again, he must be born from the instruction of the word of God, that he obey the gospel. 1 Peter 1:25. Through the revelation of Jesus, who is the way, truth, and life, all men can learn what is necessary for salvation through Jesus. John 14:6. And thus be born of the word of God. Distinguished listeners, God's word, therefore, is entirely sufficient to educate one concerning what he must do to be saved, as well as what he must do to live a Christ-centered life. The Holy Spirit will not lead us contrary to his written word. Neither will he lead us to salvation apart from what is revealed in the Bible. For David still says in Psalm 119:105, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path," unquote. Foundation number 5. Believe that man's religiosity, religions, laws, and traditions are not binding as standards by which we will be judged. Believe that man's religious laws and traditions are not binding as standards by which we will be judged. Distinguished listeners, we must understand that men do not have the right to bind on themselves mandates for salvation that are not bound by God. Binding religious traditions and laws lead us away from the commandments of God as they led the Jews away from God by the time of the ministry of Jesus. Jesus said this in Mark 7:1-9. Mark 7:1-9. It is not wrong to do something traditionally, but to make that which is traditional the law of one's religiosity is to bring one into the bondage of men and subsequently divide one believer from another. The same listeners, restorationists must affirm that any tradition that will lead us away from God must be sacrificed for the sake of staying close to the word of God. They must be sacrificed for the sake of unity among believers. We are free to follow our traditions, but we are not free to bind our traditions in a manner that brings others into the bondage of our tradition. Distinguished listeners, point number 6, foundation principle. Believe that the word of God will produce unity among believers. And this is why the reformers did not see that it is only the word of God that can produce restoration and unity among believers. Distinguished listeners, restorationists believe that when people focus on Jesus, their direction by the word of God will always produce unity, not division. Jesus is the one who brings people together. Confused interpretations of the word of God will divide people from one another. The word of God is simply our telescope by which we discover the Son of God. Our focus is always on Jesus Christ. But we cannot have a clear focus on Jesus unless we look through the word of God. It is for this reason that there can never be any I am of Paul or I am of Cephas or I am of Apollos among the disciples of Christ. It is all I am of Christ. Distinguishedness. Calling for the restoration of simple Christianity is not easy. Those who would defend the traditions of their fathers will always stand in the way. Those who are intimidated by the religious establishment will not have the courage to take a stand for Jesus alone. Those who validate their religiosity by their own emotional experiences will always and always subject the word of God to their own feelings. Those who trust more in either pastor, priest, or pope instead of the word of God will always follow personalities over the Prince of Peace. Restoration is a struggle. It is accomplished only by the brave who concentrate Jesus in their hearts. It is accomplished by those who take a stand on the principle the Apostle Peter stated to the religious leaders of Jerusalem in Acts 5:29. Acts 5:29, I quote, "We must obey God rather than men," unquote. Highly esteemed listeners, this is where time will permit us today. But we've learned beautifully a continuation of the topic, a call for restoration. Today we've looked at very important principle. A biblical restoration principle is to go back to the Bible. It's not to look at any institution to reform it. Going back to the Bible is a biblical restoration principle. And speaking where the Bible speaks is a biblical restoration. It is not I feel and I think. And so that is point number that we learned. We've also learned about foundation for restoration. And we are saying that before we can have the restoration, these foundations should be adhered to. And they are: one, believe in a final authority that there is in religion from God. Two, believe that God's revelation is understandable. and of a simple man to understand. 3. Believe that God's word has been preserved for all men. And also 4. To believe that man's religious laws and traditions are not binding as standards by which we be judged. Then also believe that the word of God will produce unity among believers. Distinguished listeners, when we focus on this, on Jesus alone, we must obey God rather than men. And therefore, we should turn away from all traditions in religion that is bringing division from one group to the another by the sake of tradition. Any group of people calling themselves Christians, making themselves unique, they should really look at what they do. It is not on the Bible, and the difference is because of man tradition that he has imposed on them to make them unique for unique sake. We are calling such to restore to Christ, to the word of God, for unity in Christendom. May the good Lord be with us as we shall continue this wonderful discussion, God willing, next week. And stay richly blessed. Once again, this has been the Oracles of God radio broadcast, a biblical program that is run and sponsored by the Churches of Christ, which comes your way every Wednesday on Radio Universe 105.7 FM. Make a day with us, same time, God willing, next week, as God continues to unravel His priceless oracles. You are warmly invited to worship with Churches of Christ all over the country, the Pillar of Truth, where unadulterated word of God is said and God is worshipped in spirit and in truth. You may want to contact us on 024-552-7658 or send us a message on coc.radio@yahoo.com. We're also located on Facebook at Church Radio. Church Radio. Once again, I'm your brother, Eric Daco. Now may God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify us through and through. May our whole spirit, soul, and body become blameless at the appearing of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Till we meet again, stay richly blessed. Amen and good morning.
This body's dancing.